So if you're using GitHub Copilot and you're not using GitHub Copilot Labs, then you're missing out on a whole plethora of features and what makes GitHub Copilot awesome. Let me show you why. So in order to install GitHub Copilot Labs, you just have to do a search for it on the extension store, GitHub Copilot Labs, install it. And once you have it installed, you'll see an option right here on the left that I already have selected. So I have this code right here for this React hook in here. And there's already some pre-configured stuff that you can do. You can highlight code and have it explain it to you by asking GitHub Copilot. You can have it translate code by highlighting it and selecting a different language that you'd like it to try to translate to. But all the fun is in the brushes. In the brushes, you can do all sorts of different things. So if I didn't know exactly what the code did in here and I wanted to know, I couldn't remember, I can ask it to list the steps and it will annotate the code and list out the steps for me in comments. This is much easier than using standard GitHub Copilot where you have to type in the comments and then wait for prompts and like let it autofill. Instead, you can use GitHub Copilot Labs and use a UI to trigger certain events. But where the real fun is with GitHub Copilot Labs is the custom button. Now this is where things can get really interesting. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to highlight my code and I'm gonna click custom. And we're gonna have a free form text field to ask GitHub Copilot to do something for us instead of doing comments or clicking buttons. So what I'm gonna ask it to do is let's refactor the code to combine our broadcast config, global config, and features to a single use state. So once we ask it to refactor our code and combine it in single use state, now we can see changes have occurred. So now we have one set config, and then if we look at the changes that it did, you could see that it, instead of me having three separate set states, it's using the one object and setting the features in here and doing all the same code, but now it's tweaked it. So that's really awesome change. And all we had to do was ask it. The next thing I want to do is, I'm not really digging this right here with the question mark operator. I really enjoy using ReactJS. So you can also ask GitHub Copilot Labs to refactor things using different libraries. So what I'm going to do is let's highlight this and let's go to custom again. Factor to use Ramda. And after asking it, it ended up refactoring it to use ReactJS and using Pathor for the optional in case the content doesn't exist inside its Twitch configuration. One thing to note is that since it's refactoring it and you're asking for the library will not be imported. So we would just need to go into here and import our Pathor into Ramda and make things a little bit cleaner. So GitHub Copilot is a really cool tool, but GitHub Copilot Labs launches it to the next level with the custom feature. So if you're already using GitHub Copilot, go and install the GitHub Copilot Labs extension and start using these features, especially my favorite, the custom feature. So if you like this video, please consider hitting the subscribe button. I have a goal of getting 1,000 subscribers this year, and every subscriber means a lot to me. Thank you very much. Hope you enjoy the video.